India's forests are home to diverse wildlife that continue to fascinate nature lovers from around the world. From beautiful birds to the majestic elephants, there is endless variety on offer. However, the tiger continues to be the star attraction of the Indian jungles. To better protect tigers, it is important to know their current numbers. For this, in partnership with NTCA, WII and Forest Departments, WWF India is participating in estimation of tigers across India using camera traps.
Earlier, you were trying to estimate tiger numbers through a census, where you actually go and count the number of animals in a reserve based on their pug marks. Now, it is universally accepted that pug marks are not a foolproof system. They're very faulty because a single tiger can have different, you know, kind of pug marks. We get a lot more information over the long term by using inexpensive camera traps and also to prove tiger occupancy. Like they say, a picture is worth 1,000 words. You can write a report about a landscape. You get one picture of a tiger in a corridor, you prove that the corridor is being used by that animal. So people are more convinced it is the best method we have about counting tigers. We have our camera traps running in the Western Ghats, Pakhe and Ameri in the Northeast, and Pilibhit, close to Corbett.
Pilibhit is located about 275 kilometers from New Delhi in northern Uttar Pradesh. The forests of Pilibhit offer a good habitat for a wide variety of wildlife. In partnership with the Pilibhit Forest Department, WWF India's researchers conducted a tiger science survey for the selection of suitable camera trap locations. On the basis of the presence of different signs like pug marks, scrapes, rakes, scats, suitability of the area for setting up a camera trap was determined. On the basis of the sign survey, 30 best locations were selected for setting up camera traps.
Tigers have got unique stripe patterns, so you can identify individual tigers just like you can through fingerprints in humans. So once you get enough number of pictures of tigers from a reserve, then you can estimate it through a process called mark recapture. So you don't have to get every tiger in the reserve, but if you can get a certain amount of tigers and again have those tigers recaptured in the camera trap pictures, then through a formula you can estimate the number of tigers in that protected area.
For mounting the camera, as you can see, lots of grasses are there, so we have to clear the area. In this camera, this is a flash. And this point is a lens which captures the picture, and this is a thermo motion sensor. This sensor triggers the camera to click the pictures, and we have to wrap it round. It is ready for clicking the picture of a tiger. We used to check the data after every third day or fourth day, and we download the data after every 10th day.
The camera traps revealed the diverse animals inhabiting the Pilibhit forests like porcupine, fishing cat, rusty spotted cat, honey badger, common leopard, common palm civet, sloth bear, and of course the tiger, indicating the presence of a fairly good tiger density in these forests.
How this helps tiger conservation is that unless you know what is available in your parks, you cannot know if you are conserving or managing these tigers well.
WWF is working very closely with the forest department. Over these last 6-7 years, we were not having any scientific baseline data. So this exercise really helped for us all to know what is the baseline of the tiger estimates in the Pilibhit forest regions.
Such camera trapping exercises will go a long way in better management of tigers of India in general and Pilibhit in particular.